I hope you're ready. People tend to forget how truly terrifying a fantasy can really be, right? So was there anything that you felt that was important to lean towards as far as like the horror aspect of the movie is concerned and really like implement?
Well, the best horror movies have this sort of be careful what you wish for kind of undercurrent. I mean, if you really study horror films, I think they all have that. It's like, yeah, I want to be young, I want to have fun, I want to have sex, I want to do drugs, I want to go to parties, and then suddenly there's like Michael Myers there, right? Like there is that be careful what you wish for kind of thing, this morality that's always being reinforced by truly great horror movies. And so Fantasy Island just naturally lent itself to that kind of storytelling.
So,
bloody disgusting.
Look
here
at
we
us.
Go.
I'm a huge horror fan. I gotta ask, how are you with horror films?
I love horror movies.
You do?
I do. I especially love kind of the older ones. Like I guess you can consider them old, but like The Shining still, like to me, is amazing. Rosemary's Baby, Mia Farrow is like unreal. You know, I remember my brother really used to like it, and then I liked, and he actually made the Freddy Krueger. Nightmare on Elm Street. He made the,
you know, iconic
glove. Yeah, because my dad and my brother really liked, you know, making things,
yeah.
And so he made the iconic glove with like. My mom didn't make them; they weren't like real like razor blade knives, but it looked really cool. And I was like, wow, this is awesome.
That's super cool.
Yeah, so we watched a lot of horror movies, especially you know when we were younger.
Nice. So in your career, you've obviously done a lot of things, from singing to mysteries to comedy,
mm-hmm.
And a lot of people say that like horror and comedy go hand in hand.
Yeah.
What is it about this genre that draws you in?
I've just loved the genre ever since I was a little kid. I think that like I have a line in Fantasy Island where it says that's why we ride roller coasters and watch horror movies, because we want to feel something. And I think that that's it. I think that's why people love to watch them, because it makes them feel very present and alive.
Yeah.
Yes. And I love that feeling.
So Fantasy Island, if you were to actually go there today,
what
would
my fantasy?
Your fantasy
yeah.
Would
be? I have a few. You know, I've been saying some stuff about my dog. I'll give you a different one. I love Elvis Presley. Like just like hang out with Elvis Presley
That's
for a day.
That's a really, really
I have so
good
many
one.
Questions for him.
What are you kind of hoping that fans take away from this film?
I hope that they're scared,
okay.
To be honest with you. I'm like, and you know, I was definitely intrigued, and I hope that they like the story.
I hope fans take away from this film that they had a really good time. I mean, it was a chance for me to do this crazy genre mashup, like reference all these great horror movies. Saw,
I love
Purge, Butterfly Effect, like all these different genres, right, of within the horror landscape I tried to reference within our film. I got to make four different little movies and then have them crash together. So I hope people take away from it that they just had a great time, that they saw so much more than they expected.
What's this place?
Welcome to Fantasy Island. Here, anything and everything is possible.
The island is twisting our fantasies.
This is not what I meant.
I think this is someone else's fantasy.
This isn't real.
You are not real.
Fantasy Island, rated PG-13.